ऑप्शन।
ओके लेट्स ट्राई नाउ। ओके मेघना,
मैम इज दिस स्क्रीन विजिबल?
यस,
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई एम हियर टू टेक द प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन एक्टिव स्पोर्ट्स वेयर फॉर मेन एंड वुमेन। सो स्पोर्ट्स वेयर इज अ टाइप ऑफ क्लोथिंग दैट पीपल वेयर व्हेन दे एक्सरसाइज, गो फॉर रन, प्ले स्पोर्ट एक्सेट्रा। इट इज एनी क्लोथिंग वॉर्न व्हेन यू इंडल्ज इन अ फिजिकल एक्टिविटी। In order to make your workout session comfortable, you need clothing that reduces perspiration and enables you to move swiftly. So first, let me say about active sportswear. 1 minute, ma'am.
Okay, take your time. No need to worry about anything.
So there is a difference between active sportswear and sportswear. Sportswear refers to the clothing that has been designed especially for sports purposes, and active wear refers to the clothing that has been designed for exercising. Both sportswear and active wear have become fashion forward trends among those leading an active lifestyle. And there are different materials used in active sportswear. So, about the many materials mean cotton, calico, microfiber, wool, polyester, nylon, and many more. So, let me tell about these about cotton. Earlier, the belief that the masses was cotton is a material that does not absorb sweat, so it is not a good option for active wear. However, of late, cotton sportswear is being made available as it has better odor management compared to the other materials, and it is so breathable and does not hold on to the stench. However, when it becomes to a quick sweat absorbing, cotton still lags behind. Next material is calico. Calico is a subtype of cotton. It is an unprocessed version of cotton that is equally soft. This material is highly absorbent, which makes it a good choice for active wear clothing. So it is also a very environmental friendly. Next is microfiber. Microfiber, as the name suggests, is a material made of fine, tiny thread of fibers, with a linear density of not more than one denier.
Okay, 1 minute,
This means
Anna.
yes, ma'am.
Are you changing the slides?
Ma'am, no, ma'am.
No. Okay, it's fine. It's fine. I thought you were changing and we were ha not able to see it. Okay, it's fine. It's fine. Continue. Continue.
So about microfiber, it means that thread that is 100 times finer than human hair. It is not naturally occurring, but man-made. Microfiber is an expensive material and often used in branded active wear. So next is about polyester. Polyester is another common type of material used in sportswear. It is basically cloth made of plastic fibers, making it lightweight, wrinkle-free, long-lasting, and breathable. It is non-absorbent in nature, which means that your sweat is not absorbed by this cloth, but left to dry on its own. It's a good choice for both hot and cold weather. Next is about nylon. Nylon is a very soft material with a texture just like silk and is known to dry quickly. Nylon also wicks quick sweat and helps in easy evaporation. Nylon has good stretch and recovery capacity. So these are just some of the materials used. There are many more. Sportswear is not just created from one material, but there are multiple options available. We can go even eco-friendly and enjoy our sport or a good workout session. So now we'll go for men's sportswear. About men's sportswear, there are different types of vest, training tights. As you can see here, the cross trainer shorts, sleeveless training shirt, long sleeve shirt, gym training tank tops, sleeveless hoodies, and many more. So let me say about the first, the dry fit full sleeve shirt. It's like you no longer have to feel like sponging wet sponge after finishing your workout, because this t-shirt handles sweat much as better than plain old cotton. The short sleeve fitted t-shirt comprises of dry fit technology that helps to keep you dry during the tough workouts. Its moisture wicking feature functions incredibly during all seasons. Next is about running vest. Running vest is specially designed for athletic men exercising in cold weather. It's an excellent piece of athletic top that provides you sufficient warmth and insulation to sustain your performance in chilling weather conditions. It is water repellent, finishing also keeps you dry during the wet condition. Next is about a sleeveless training shirt. The shirt is the combination of non-sleeves and relaxed design offers freedom of movement without any difficulty. It also comprises of dry fit technology that helps you to rid moisture and provides a cooling effect. Next is about the long sleeve compression t-shirt, another athletic wear that's popular among successful athletes around the world. It comprises of stretch mesh underarm panels that provide necessary ventilation to different parts of the body. It not only offers the anti-odor technology, but also the UPF 30 plus feature helps to protect your skin from the scorching sun. Next is about women's wear. It is one of the massive revolution and transformation that came in the sportswear field from fashion. From crop tops and hoodies to joggers and swimsuit, the whole dynamics of athletic wear for women has changed a great deal on the basis of this movement, which is basically a trend in which fitness and workout specific clothes can also be worn in a variety of other occasions and settings. So these are some of the pictures here showing women's wear about in active sportswear. So first, let me say about tank tops. This is a type of sleeveless shirt that is typically worn as an undershirt by both men and women. They're often worn with suits and dress shirts, but most popularity and traditionally tank tops are worn by women as athletic and sportswear. Tank tops are an excellent fitness clothing option given the way that they're designed and manufactured. They usually have large armholes and neck holes that ensure great durability. They also allow passing of air through the fabric during an intense workout. Next is about full sleeve shirt. These shirts are a type of active wear for women who wish to cover their arms while they are working out in the gym or are out in the field. These kinds of workout clothes are great during warm-up sessions where you can also ditch tank tops and can just begin your workout in your sleeve tops. They are also often meant to be a tight fit, so they are made from materials that easily stick to the body and don't get in the way of your fitness regime. Next is about the most common sweatshorts. Sweatshorts are most commonly worn by men nowadays. Even women are wearing them in preferred active wear and athletic wear. They are as comfortable as sweatpants, except that they're quick drying, so they make a great option for summers. Sweatshorts offer an excellent alternative to nylon and mesh shorts, as they help you give the edge you need to have a great athletic performance. This is just a fact that why isn't 100% cotton leggings used for athletic apparel? So one of the most popular used natural fibers, it's 100% cotton, is ideal for sweaty activities. It is highly hydrophilic and can retain 25% extra its weight in water, thereby taking a long time to dry. Also, cotton can lead to chafing and even cause hypothermia in winter. Unless cotton is blended with other fabric, it is not suited for athletic leggings. So the fitness and sports fashion industry first saw a major push into mainstream media in early 2014 when fashions and style blogs started to talk about how the athletic wear industry was seeing a moment in fashion. The most unique aspects of sports outfits fashion is that even if wearers don't particularly enjoy doing exercise or visiting the gym, they're showing up dressed in perfect gym attire. So there are many major sports brands such as Puma, Nike, Adidas, which previously catered specifically to people who actually played sports, suddenly find themselves producing leisure wear for those who simply wanted to look good while doing nothing. So modern peoples are paying more attention to sports activity. During designing the sportswear fabric, the aspects which are considered as protection, safety, functions to protect wearers from adhesive weather, comfort functions with give wear comfort, that is thermal sensor and body movement comfort, exercise function to enhance the performance of athlete, and aesthetic appeal and high fashion ability. Thank you.
Very well done, Anna. We can stop there. So I would like to ask you one question. Apart from being hydrophilic and all, if what will happen? What is the problem with using 100% cotton in active sportswear? What is the problem?
The volume is very low, ma'am. Volume.
Volume. Okay, sir.
Magna and Steffi, no video problem.
They are having a network issue, sir.
Am I audible, sir?
Yeah. Now it's okay.
Okay. The question is, Anna. Oh, okay, Steffi, okay. The question is, as you said, cotton is hydrophilic. It does take a long time to dry and all, right? If while working out, while performing active sports, yes, we will get wet easily. So apart from all these factors, what will happen if we use 100% cotton in making active sportswear?
Cotton is a material that doesn't absorb sweat easily, so it is not a good option for active wear.
Okay. Cotton absorbs sweat, but the problem with cotton is that cotton is not stretchable. Okay. Cotton is not stretchable. That is one main reason. So we use cotton along with materials like viscose and spandex in order to make it stretchable. So the percentage will be 25% cotton and 75% spandex, like that. Majority will be spandex or other stretchable materials. So in order to make the apparel more stretchable, more comfortable, more suitable for performing activities, so that there will be no restrictions in performing any activity, so that you can easily walk, you can easily jog, you can easily do yoga or other cardio activities. Okay, so in order to make it more comfortable, more proper for performing that particular activity, they mix cotton along with other suitable materials. Okay, so another question is that what kind of wear apparel do these volleyball players, basketball players, do they use? What kind of apparel do they use?
T-shirt, jerseys.
So just like gym workout and all, there is not much restrictions there, right? So they can use jersey, they will be wearing loose fitted trousers, shorts and t-shirts, right? Not much restrictions there. Okay, very good. Very good, Anna. Very well explained.
Thank you, ma'am.
You covered all the topics that were necessary. Okay, very well. Very well done. Okay. Nidhi, I think she joined a few minutes ago, but I guess she is facing some kind of network issue. Okay. So I want you all to go and pick some t-shirts, some kurtis, bag, handbag. Maybe you can also take footwear so that we can have a discussion about trims that is used in apparel. Okay, so go get your stuff fast. Okay. Thank you. Hello. Are you guys there?
Ma'am, Nidhi message is having network issues. She's joining.
Sorry, Malavika.
She messaged me. She is trying to enter. She joined now, ma'am.
Nidhi.
Yes, ma'am. She is having network issues.
Network issues. Okay. Meghna, Steffi, are you guys there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Nidhi is having network issues, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So you all have your stuff with you, right? Garments, apparel, t-shirts, shirts, whatever it is, bag, shoes. Okay. So take any of them in your hand. Okay, so we will be talking about trim. Okay. So we were talking about apparel categories, different apparel categories, women's wear, men's wear, children's wear, from which we learned about active sports wear, the different types of fabrics, colors, silhouettes, everything, right? Right, we discussed about all these factors in the last few classes. So in this class, we will be talking about trims. So what? What is trim? What are? What are they? So, take your shirt or t-shirt, whatever you are having in your hand. Let me see. I'm wearing a shirt right now. Okay. I'm wearing a shirt today. So, in the basic form, basically, before converting it into a shirt, it was a piece of fabric, right? It was a piece of fabric. All the garments, before it coming into that garment form, all of them were just a piece of fabric, right? In order to convert all these fabrics into the form that we are having right now, into the form of a t-shirt, into the form of jeans, in the form of a shirt, kurti, blouse, jacket, hoodies, whatever it is. In order to convert this piece of fabric into a piece of garment, we need to stitch it. First, we will cut it using different patterns. After that, we will stitch it, right? Stitch it using thread. Right. We use matching color thread to stitch the garments, right? So threads used for stitching is a trim. Okay. So everything that is used in a garment or a piece of apparel, apart from fabric, everything is called a trim. Okay. Everything which is used in an apparel, whether it, in an accessory, apart from the basic material that is fabric, everything else is called trim. Shoe. If you take a shoe, it will be a fabric or leather, sewed leather. It can be any material, right? Apart from this basic material, all the other things like there will be this lace for tying, there will be some embellishment on the shoe. Right, there will be some stickers and all. So apart from the basic material, which is fox leather, sewed leather, or a cloth, corduroy, whatever the basic material is, apart from that, everything used in that particular piece is called trim. Okay, so when it comes to a garment, when it comes to this shirt, the thread used for stitching it is a trim. The buttons used here is a trim. Okay. There will be a tag inside, right? Showing my size. Which size this apparel is. That is a trim. Okay. there will be a brand tag that is a trim. So let me know what all kind of trims are there in your piece of garment. So Raina, let's start with you, Raina. It's clear, right? If you have any doubt, just ask me. No need to worry about anything. It's just us. You don't have to pressurize yourself. Be free. Go through your garment. You know everything other than your fabric that is used in your garment, that is used in your accessory, handbags, shoes, everything other than the basic material is a trim. Okay. So let me know what all are there. So in the shirt, it's only thread and buttons and that tag. Care tag is there, wash care tag is there, brand tag is there, and size tag is there. Apart from that, it's just that much. The trims are that much. So let's hear it from you, Raina. Just go through your garment, whatever it is, whether it is a kurta, pajama, t-shirt, whatever it is, just go through it. Just let me know what all trims are used in that particular piece of garment. All of you, just go through it. Be ready with your list. Okay, list of trims.
Ma'am, it means like what all used in garment?
Yes.
To stitch?
Not to stitch. Everything apart from fabric. Okay. Fabric is the basic material. If there is an interlining, there is lining. There will be lining for some dresses, right? For kurtas, there will be lining. Even that lining is a trim. Okay. There will be canvas used in collars. That is a trim. For sure, in shirt collars, shirt cuffs, in salwar, necklines, there will be canvas. These canvas is called interlining. And this interlining is also a trim. The lining that is used in your kurtis and all, that is also a trim. Everything apart from the basic garment that is used in a that is used is trim. Okay. Even the sequins, beads, buttons. Okay. Everything is a trim. Okay. Raina. Are you ready? Zipper is a trim. Hook is a trim. Thread is a trim. Yes,
Raina. Ma'am, prince.
Prints, not prints. Prints is just paintings, right? So it's not a material. Okay. That is there on that basic material that is used. Prints are already there. It's a printed fabric.
Ma'am, only in this garment is used thread.
Thread.
To no. Stitch. And this tag.
Okay. It's a very simple kurti. Okay. Tag. Yes. Very good. It's random. Okay. So it's simple. Okay. What about Anna?
Ma'am, for my shirt, buttons.
Buttons is there.
The size tag and
okay.
The tag.
That's it.
Then for my kurti, it's the interlining. Interlining is shown with buttons and all. Like, near the collar, there's a lining.
There's a lining, yes.
Okay.
A piping is there, yes.
Then
the printed buttons is there, yes. Okay. So you all understood that's the concept trim, right? You know what is a trim right now. So yes, if ma'am. You take a bag, if you take a leather bag, everything that is used apart from that leather, the zippers, the lining material, there will be some embellishment buttons, fancy metal buttons and rings will be there in a bag, right? So all these are trims only. Okay. Okay. So Malavika, do you have anything apart from kurti and t-shirt? You have a handbag with you?
I have a hoodie.
Sorry, Malavika?
I have a hoodie.
Hoodie?
Yes,
okay,
ma'am.
Okay.
In that brand label is there.
Brand
a
label.
Drawstring.
A drawstring is there. Very good.
A tag which shows its size.
Okay. A tag is there.
No.
A zipper will be there, right? Is
no,
it trend opening?
No.
There is no opening. It's just a... Okay. And to pass the drawstring, there will be a round metallic ring will be there on the hoodie.
Yes,
so that is a trim. Okay. If there is zipper, that zipper is a trim. The thread is a trim. Never forget. Because thread is a simple thing. So because of that, never forget that trim. Thread is a trim. Okay. So while telling what all trims are used in a garment, never forget thread. Start with thread. Thread is there, zipper is there, button is there, that metallic ring is there. Buckle is there, drawstring is there. Okay. Okay. If elastic is used, elastic is there. Okay, Meghna.
I have elastic, beads, then stitch or thread. Then
thread.
Label name and size tag.
Size label is there. Okay. So wash care label. Care labels will be there. Then size label will be there. Brand label will be there. Brand label is something that will show us which brand product is that, right? Whether it is H&M, whether it is Zara, whether it is Levi's. Like that, there will be a brand tag. There will be a size tag which shows which size product is it. Medium, small, extra small, large, extra large, double XL. When it comes to shirt, men's shirt, it will be 38, 40, 42, 44, like that. When it comes to jeans, yes, Raina.
Ma'am, I forgot to show one more thing.
Okay.
Wash and care tag.
Wash care label. Okay, okay, very good. So that is also a trim. And wash care label, there will be a lot of symbols in it, which shows, do not wrinkle. So we will, you don't have to learn those symbols now. So those symbols indicate that do not wrinkle after wash. You should wash in cold water or mild hot water. You should not use what soap. Dry clean only. Do not iron. Like that, different symbols will be there on the wash care label. So wash care label is basically for you to know how to take care of that particular piece of garment for it to last long. Okay. For it to last long. Okay, that is the purpose of wash care label. So is that clear? Okay, Steffi. Steffi?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, trim.
Okay.
So when it comes to jeans, what all trims are there? Just think about a jean, a pair of jeans. Zipper will be there, yes.
A side lining.
Yes. A metallic okay. button will be there, right?
Yeah. Then tag.
Tag, thread. Okay.
What is the spelling of this word, trips?
Trim. T-R-I-M-S. Trim.
C. C?
Not C, sir. T. T-R-I-M-S. Trim.
T-R-I?
No, sir. I will share the board. I will just write it on the board. Okay, Raina. So we okay, Steffi.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Steffi.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You have your piece of garment or accessory with you, right? A bag, a shoe. Belt,
yes,
maybe.
Ma'am.
Okay. So tell me what all trims are used in it.
It has a trim on the sole of the footwear.
Mm-hmm. Sole is there, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Just that.
Ma'am, it's kind of like an open sandal, so it just has the trim on the sole.
Okay, so a thread is used for stitching it, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So a thread is a trim. I told you to not forget about it. Just one of the common trims, right? It is used in everything. So never forget about thread. Okay.
Okay.
Just because it is a basic one, don't forget about it. Okay. Okay. So Nidhi is not here and Sana is not here. So if Nidhi joins in the next class, we will take her presentation. Otherwise, no chance. I will be marking her based on her previous presentation. Okay, any doubts? Regarding anything, apparel categories, till whatever we discussed till this moment. Trim, apparel categories, women's wear, men's wear, children's wear. Any doubt? No doubt. Nothing. I want you to respond. If you don't have any doubt, just tell me you don't have any doubt. Okay, Raina.
No,
yeah. No. Okay.
No,
good. So in the next class, I think it was an afternoon session, we will be discussing unit 2, continuation. Okay. So we discussed till basic pattern development methods, right? Flat pattern method, draping method. You all remember it, right? You all remember, right? Flat pattern method, draping method. We saw a video of draping method. We saw how a pattern is developed through draping method. We discussed about different parts, different measurements. Right.
So yes.
We will be continuing that chapter in the next session, which is an afternoon session. Okay. So just go through whatever we discussed and we will be learning some terminologies related to pattern development. Okay. So bye. Let's wind up today's session. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.